Stadium just outside Miami and the home of the FIU Panthers. We are anxiously awaiting a battle as this fan base is ready to show everyone worldwide what FIU football is all about. Today, these two squads square off in a Conference USA showdown. As we'll see, the Sam Houston Bearcats taking on the Florida International Panthers. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Reese Davis, joined here in the booth by David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. And guys, let's get this thing started. FIU will kick it off to get things underway. He'll bring it out. It's Phillips. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. The Bearcats offense will get the first crack at it here. And when you take the field with the confidence, the swag that this guy does, David, it just really elevates your confidence in the passing game.
Yeah, receivers don't usually lack confidence, and those are the guys that kind of set the tone. And that swagger sets the tone for this offense. And, Jesse, you know he's going to make plays.
And that speed scares defenses, too, because he can take the top off quick. These safeties better get back deep or else this guy's going to take it to the house.
After the 3-yard pickup, they come to the line, 2nd and 7. They'll go to the ground. Tripped up at the 25 after picking up 4.
And runs like that are like body blows in a boxing match. 4, 5, 6-yard gains early turn into 20, 30, 40-yard gains later. They really wear down defenses, and they test their physicality.
They'll need 3 yards here on 3rd down to keep this opening drive alive. On the option. He'll toss it. And that might have been a bad read as the defense just swarms all over the pitch man.
Man, this is a defense that prides themselves on stopping the run, and that is a huge statement on their opponent's opening drive of the game. 3rd and short, they don't just get a stop. They get a tackle for loss. That sends a very clear message that they're going to be the more physical side today.
4th down, and the punt team sends it the other way. He'll be content with the field position, making the fair catch right around the 30-yard line. The Panthers offense headed onto the field. Our first look at them today. As we take a look at our impact players for this one, what are you looking for, Jesse, for a guy to make an impact?
Well, these are simply put the leaders of this football team, and generally games go how these guys play. If they make plays, then they've got a shot to win this one.
No doubt, they got to show up. These are the team leaders. These guys have to play well if they're going to win the football game.
Well, they're trying to run the football there, just nowhere to go. They got dominated up front at the point of attack.
FIU pushing tempo. Quarterback on the keeper. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
And this is a defense that prides themselves on their ability to go sideline to sideline. It's going to be tough for this offense to go QB option in this game. And you just saw the speed of the defense right there getting a big stop.
Now this offense facing a 3rd and long from their own 30. Back to throw, it's Jenkins. Fires to the wideout. That was almost picked off, and what a disaster that would have been to throw a pick on the opening drive. Instead, it's 4th down.
And that's why that guy plays DB and not wide receiver. DBs generally don't have as good of hands as wide receivers. That ball should have been picked off on 3rd down. Come on, man. That could have been a pick 6.
4th down, and the punt team sends it the other way. Makes a move. Coverage team gets the job done, and they'll mark him down at the 38-yard line. The Bearcat offense ready to go back to work. The last time we saw this offense, we had to look quick. It was a 3 and out, Jesse.
He just had no rhythm in that last drive, so someone's going to have to step up.
Gives him a little shake, and he's got some room. And they're getting it rolling with that play to the 42-yard line.
This is why everybody grows up and wants to be an offensive coordinator and not a defensive coordinator, because he can do that. He drops back. He's supposed to pass, but you know what? I'll just scramble around, and I'll just go get plenty of yards and pick him up and put him down, and I'm faster than most of your other guys, too, so good luck stopping him.
give to the back. A strong tackle and wrap up from the junior.
And these defensive tackles just eat people. They swallow human beings when you get near them. They're so big, so strong. When those guys, those running backs come in, they just need a mitt. They put one mitt on a running back, and he usually falls to the ground just because of their sheer mass and strength.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and nine. Able to pick his way forward for a decent game before the defense gets him down. Here on third down, will they go back to the running game? To the air, it's Bauer. That, friends, is a busted play. Incomplete.
Really nice job by the defense. The offense has the whole playbook open to him on third and short. They try to slip in the screen. Did not fool the defense at all. Nice stop by the defense.
And now on fourth down, they'll try a field goal. This is going to have to be unleashed from 54 yards out. That is no good. After the miss, no change in the score. FIU gets it back, and the Panthers will send the offense back onto the field. Boy, three and out last time, Davey. They'd like to be more productive this time around.
Yeah, in the last drive, nothing really clicked. No rhythm. Got off the field really, really quickly.
And that pressure just engulfed him. A sack for this defense. After the big first down sack, it's second down. They'll run it from the gun. Not a lot of daylight. He gets one to the 32.
You know, I think a big part of this isn't necessarily scoring a touchdown on that play, but you're just trying to get your offensive line in the rhythm of the game. Let those big fellas get lathered up.
I'm not positive, but that first down marker might be in the next county. On third and long, hoping to throw beyond the sticks. Catch in the middle, it's Lawrence. And sure, tackling there to keep him from getting to the first down marker.
You gotta love that. On defense, one of the most critical statistics out there is how do you play on third down? How do you prevent the opponent from keeping drives alive? Right there, tackling the catch, you gave up the completion, whoop-de-doo. You set up fourth and long, you're gonna get the ball back. Go get some water and celebrate.
Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. Really good job by the coverage team to make the stop, and that's where they'll put it in play. The Bearcat offense ready to go back to work. We talk about settling for points, but sometimes when you have to settle for nothing, David, it can be demoralizing.
Yeah, and it can definitely be frustrating. And I think it leads you to say maybe I go for it more, but Jesse, I think this offense just needs to put another drive together and just finish stronger.
Yeah, and be a little bit less predictable, too, especially as they get closer and closer down to the end zone.
Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. Out of the gun, the inside handoff, looking for a crease. Defense closed down quickly after a gain of three. They'll mark it at the 32. If they can convert here, that type of play can really give you a shot of momentum. Looking to throw, it's Bauer. Under heavy pressure, lets it fly. And that ball is hauled in inside the 35.
Man, if I'm a defense, I got to find a way to get some more pressure on the quarterback or disrupt their timing and their rhythm. I can't give them these big chunk plays through the air. I got to be maybe a little bit more aggressive or do something a little bit different.
And the Bearcats want to crank the tempo. All kinds of to throw that one in there. And he got away from the defense and takes it in. Touchdown, Bearcats!
Quarterback's abilities to read the field is huge, and also the anticipation, the timing. To be able to throw the football, Jesse, and hit a guy in stride so he can get run after the catch and get in the end zone, that was a nice job by the quarterback.
Yeah, it's critical, David. Listen, a lot of times, touchdown passes aren't thrown into the end zone. You've got to read the coverage, hit the open guy, and let him do the rest.
PAT unit on the field. And the PAT makes it 7-0. Quick work on that scoring drive, just 4 plays. And they top it off with a 31-yard toss for 6. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And he passes on the touchback. Here he comes. Pulled down at the 18, and the decision to bring it out of the end zone was not a good one. The Florida International offense is back on the field. From the gun, they'll try to impose their running game. He is going nowhere. Stop at the line of scrimmage.
And just a great job by the defense being stout, right? That's your job. Be stout up front, stuff in the run play, make them get in more passing situations, but do not let them run the football. That's 101. Stop the run first.
They got nothing on the last play. It's 2nd and 10. Looking to pass. It's Jenkins. Makes his connection. Really nice job there by both guys, the throw and the catch, to work that defense and get the first down.
Nice patience by the quarterback here working against zone coverage. He was allowing his receiver an opportunity to find that open space in the defense before pulling the trigger.
It'll be 1st and 10 from the 30. That's the end of the period, and Sam Houston has the lead. We've put one in the books. Let's have a look at our game summary. Now to see if these guys can get back in the game as we open the second quarter. They say success rate can be picking up about 4 or so on 1st down, 1st and 10. Couldn't find a lane, a pickup of 1 to the 31.
And offenses want to continue to feature the run. They want balance. Even if it's not super successful, you can take it little bit at a time just to keep that defense honest.
FIU pushing tempo. Back to the ground game on the left. He's there to make the stop.
How about the defender being a heat-seeking missile? He was on radar lock. He found the football and flew down with some bad intentions.
They line up, and it is a long way to the sticks from here. On 3rd and long, trying to have a big completion here. He'll pull it down and run. Nice run there, picks up a few, and they'll force him out of bounds.
And I think this is important for this defense. This will be a big key in the football game. Like, I got to limit the damage from that guy, because that's a QB that's dynamic, and he can make so many big plays. I got to string him out. I got to make him get to the sideline. But I will say this. I do want to hit him at the end of the runs. I don't want to let him out of bounds and let him get free carries. I want it to be physical.
On the return, it's Allen. He gets it up to the 34-yard line before he stopped, and that's where the offense will set up shop. Looking for a productive play on 1st down. From the gun, the running back has it. Dances away from one. You want to make sure to maximize those types of runs, and he gets it out to the 41.
You want to talk about making it easy for an offensive coordinator. You pick up a bunch of yards on 1st down, make that 2nd down really, really manageable. That's a great job by the offense.
Good spot after that 7-yard pickup on 1st down. It's 2nd and 3. From the shotgun, they'll run it. And he gets it to the 45-yard line, and that'll be a 1st down.
All right, nothing flashy there. He just did what it took to get the 1st down.
They move the chains on the ground. Now another first down. Scanning the field, it's Bauer. Got his man to the left. And they reacted well to the completion, but it was too late to keep him from getting the first down.
When you run those routes, those curl routes just like that, those DBs are going to break when you go to throw the football. So you better put that thing on a line. And the QB did there. Put it on a line. Great job. Great catch. First down.
They go to the ground. They make the stop, but this running game moves the chains as they get the first down.
First down, physicality wins football games. Being able to run the football and create balance. And right here, just chews up another first down, gives you another chance to maybe continue to run the football.
And I feel like this guy, too, is just an explosive play waiting to happen. His vision, his quickness, and he's got a burst. If you give this guy just a crease, he's going to hit it. And right now, he's doing some damage on this defense.
He's there to make the stop, but not before he sets up this offense first and goal from the 7.
It is so good for an offense early in the game to get in a rhythm and to start stringing first downs together. It makes the game really easy and puts that defense in a situation where they're starting to get tired. They want to sub. They want to get other guys in the field. Stringing first downs together like this makes it hard to defend.
Knocked down after a gain of 1. They'll mark it at the 6. Now the offense tries to punch it in on 2nd and goal. He's looking to throw. Going for 6. Can't hang on in the end zone, and that one is going to drive him crazy when he watches it. It'll be 3rd down.
Well, I love the coverage on defense. In the red zone, everyone's got their eyes on the quarterback, and they're flying to the football, and you saw that there on the incompletion.
They've already squandered a couple of chances to score touchdowns in the red zone, and now another opportunity. It's 3rd and goal. Looking to the end zone. Fires into traffic. Picked off. That's why you love veterans in this defense. They stay locked in on their rules, and he made the pick.
Who says defensive backs don't have hands? Nice job breaking on the football and making the catch. A lot of times you see guys swat it down or you see them trying to catch it. It looks like they have 2 left hands. Defensive backs don't catch real well. Nice job breaking on the football. Nice job securing the INT and actually catching it.
Guys, FIU ready to go back to work on offense. Their drive chart is starting to look a little monotonous. Punt, 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 David.
And their defense is starting to get a little frustrated, too. They just keep putting me back on the field, possession after possession. Jesse, this offense needs to get their heads out of their you-know-whats.
The punter's on the sideline with the oxygen mask right now. He's been playing so much. He's not used to this. This offense, they just got to stay on the field. They've got to put a drive together and get some balance going, running and throwing the ball.
The give to the back. Finds that crease, and he's got 4 out to the 29.
Offensive linemen love to run the power. Why? You run power. You run power. Then you can play action. You don't want that defense to be sitting there saying, it's a pass, it's a pass, having to pass block every play. You got to keep defenses off balance.
The Panthers will hustle to the line. On 3rd and short, just trying to get enough for the first down. He'll be stopped short, picks up 1, but they're facing 4th and 1.
Well, the offense is trying to get it down on the ground there on 3rd down, but they just can't seem to make it work because of how physical the defense has been, guys. It's made this offense very one-dimensional. I mean, the only way it seems they can move the football is when they try to throw it.
FIU will line up to punt. He gets it up to the 34-yard line before he stopped, and that's where the offense will set up shop. This drive will get underway from just inside the 35 at their own 34. Gets it out quickly. He's run out of bounds, but a big play on that one, and it'll be a first down.
running backs nowadays, they are wide receivers. I mean, you got to feature them in the pass game. Why? Because you get matchups on linebackers like this. Great job getting the football near the line of scrimmage. Bam, break a tackle, make something happen, get 10-plus yards.
They'll finally drag him down, but not before he gets it to the 40, and it's a first down. It's the two-minute warning, and we'll see if the offense can tack a little something extra on their lead before the break. The offense lines up at the 40. They've got a first down. Looking downfield, it's Bauer. He finds his man. A 7-yard pickup. It'll be second and 3.
I really like this slot receiver because of his shiftiness, and you see that on his route running. Really, really nice job creating separation for his QB.
That last completion sets him up on second down. He's looking to throw. A little screen to the running back. Finally run out of bounds, but he has this offense rolling with a first down. Lots of good stuff on that play. You slow down the rush, you get a completion, and you move the chains.
And most importantly, you're right. You don't force a short yardage situation that you have to get. Nice job. Invite that rush up the field. Take advantage of the aggressiveness of the defense. Make the catch. Make the run. Get the first down.
And he'll chuck that one away and save the down. Nobody was able to get open. After missing the connection last time, it's second and 10 from the 22. He'll just keep slinging it. Using the quick game. Got some room, headed to the goal line. And he'll haul it in and take it to the end zone. Touchdown, Bearcats!
This offense is really dangerous because of the weapons they have on the perimeter of the field. And you're seeing, they go to these guys early, and they try to give them opportunities in one-on-one situations and vertically down the field. Two passing touchdowns now early for this offense.
Lining up for the PAT. And the extra point makes it 14-0. So that scoring drive took only 6 plays. And it was capped with an explosive 22-yard run. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. Let's see what he can do with the return. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. FIU gets it back, and the Panthers will send the offense back onto the field. Not a lot of time left here in the half. Let's see if they can cut into this lead. He's got it downfield for a huge gain. And he's running in the open. And he ran away from the defense to take it in. Touchdown, Panthers.
And I tell you what, that passing touchdown, man, that should spark this whole team. Like, the comeback is more than on now. Like, they got the touchdown. They cut into the lead. You want to get a stop and go into the half, get all the juices, all the excitement, and be like, listen, the passing game's rolling. We got this. The comeback's in full effect.
Getting set for the point after. And it's up and good as they draw just a touch closer. If only it were always this easy for the offensive coordinators. One play, big chunk yardage, put points on the board just like that. about to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. He'll bring it out from inside his own 10. And he's able to pick his way through the traffic nicely for a good return on that one before he's brought down. Going up top on first down. Moves away as he feels pressure. Nice job of avoiding the sack and picking up a few on the run. The clock will stop with this timeout from the offense. They'll get a chance to regroup on the sideline. Now on second down. Looking for a man. It's Bauer. Right down the middle. It's caught downfield. Good pickup there as he gets the first down, and they'll mark him at the 48.
Well, and a nice job working the middle of the field. I think it's so important to keep defenses honest, and you can't just dink and dunk outside. You got to work the middle. Great job finding this wide receiver over the middle of the field.
Here they come, first and 10 from the 48. He's looking to throw it. Snares it outside. It's Evans. And he goes out of bounds after a nice pickup on that one.
Well, that's great timing by the quarterback and receiver on that out route. If you're going to be running that against man coverage like they were there, that ball has to be thrown early, and it's got to be thrown out in front of the receiver, and they execute it perfectly.
Got the completion on the last play. Still some work to do on second down. He's looking to throw. Oh, he wants it all. And he's got it inside the 20. And it is a chunk play, a huge gain on that one before the defense brings it to an end. The Bearcats come to the line with a fresh set of downs. They'll throw it from the red zone. Hit hard just as he released it on first down and just couldn't get it to the receiver.
It's hard throwing in the pocket, man. You got bodies and 300-pound dudes falling all over the place. They're trying to hit you. That time, the pressure got to them, and it forced the incompletion.
After the misfire, now on second down. He's looking to throw. Catch in the middle. It's Phillips. The offense calls timeout. It's the second one they've used this half.
Hate giving up that play if you're the DB on this one, because you're playing man coverage, you're trying to defend a slant route, you've taken the inside away. That's where your leverage is. You'll allow anything to happen to the outside. You're trying to funnel the receiver to the boundary. You just cannot let the receiver beat you to the inside.
Yeah, and third and short, they choose not to run, throw the football, and I think a lot of that has to do with they know they're in field goal range, and they can take the 3 points on the board.
And here comes the field goal unit for the second time tonight. It's good. And now the lead is extended a little further. That late in the half field goal always gives you a little boost going to the locker room, and they'll need to finish off these final few seconds and not allow them to answer. On the move from inside his 5. And the coverage team able to wrestle him down. Running out of time here in the first half, they're going to have to be efficient to put some points on the board before the break. Really nice stop there from this senior leader. First half in the books. Time now to join Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
Gentlemen, what else is new? A really raucous environment there in Miami. And we have to start this halftime breakdown by addressing the play of this elite wide receiver. This is clearly a young man who, once he's finished playing on Saturdays, he's going to be playing on Sundays. The kid has different gears. He has a knack for finding gaps in the defense. And I can't remember a college player with that kind of catch radius. And with that, let's send it back to the guys at Ricardo Silva Stadium.
The Bearcats will try to kick this one deep to get things underway in the second half. And he takes this from inside the five. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. The Florida International offense is back on the field. They are trailing by 10 here, Jesse, but this is the type of team that seems comfortable in an offensive shootout.
You got to hold serve at this point, right? You got to drive the field, put some more points up on the board. Yeah, they just scored. You can answer that now and keep this thing close, David.
And I think you're used to that as offense. Like, football is so fast-paced now and you score so quickly, it's not that big of a deal to get down 10. You keep being you, keep being aggressive.
The give on the inside. Into the pile, maybe got one. He stopped at the 21.
And a lot of times you want those big plays. You want those splash plays. But sometimes you're going to take some losses. You're not going to run the football overly well. But if you continue to run it, you can at least create some balance. You at least have the threat of it. Otherwise, you're just going to abandon it, and now it's just going to be a passing game.
On third and long, he has to throw for it. He took a hit as he threw it and couldn't deliver the football. It's incomplete, and fourth down's coming.
And you got to wonder if this offense is going to go for it here. They're trailing now by a lot. I know there's a lot of football still to go, and I know they're on their own end of the field, but just kind of get the feeling their defense hasn't gotten a ton of stops. They may need to stay out there, and they're going to need this quarterback to make a play.
He'll get away another punt. He's been really active today, and no doubt he's going to earn his varsity letter. He was working his way on the return toward midfield. They'll stop him at the 46. The Bearcat offense ready to go back to work. Always good to get points on a drive, David, but chip shot field goals can leave you a little empty.
And I think it's great to get points, but the great teams get touchdowns in the red area. You got to get out there this time and execute a little better on this drive.
You're absolutely right, David. And generally, the best red zone offenses are the ones that run the ball the best. So let's see if they can be a little bit more physical on this drive.
Line getting set on second down. From the gun, the running back tries to hit the hole. And a decent gain there before the defense makes a stop. Let's see what they do on third down. Dropping back, it's Bauer. Fires on the run. And they wanted it all on third down, but now dealing with fourth down.
Yeah, and I like the shot, the aggressive play down the field. We like throwing those jump balls up to my receiver because usually the receiver makes the play and makes the defender look bad. Nice job by the defender getting a hand on it, tipping that ball away from the wide receiver.
And the Bearcats line up to punt it away. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. He'll bring it back. It's Patterson. Was looking for more running room, but found nothing but more tacklers. He's down at the 24. Guys, FIU ready to go back to work on offense. From the gun, they'll give it on the inside. They get him stopped after a gain of 4 out to the 28.
Small gain, I know, but again, the defense knows he's going to run the football. He's willing to run the football, not just drop back and pass. Make him honor the run game. You got to do a lot of this.
FIU pushing tempo. He leaves it with his back. And he's got enough for the first down. It'll be at the 35.
And I don't care if I get it by 2, by 20, by 30, by 40. I just want to get the first down, understanding the situation, understanding where the sticks are. Doesn't have to be sexy, but I got to make sure I get to that stick, get to the first down mark.
They'll snap it on first down from the 35. He's going to pass. Throws to the wideout. Finds a man on the left. Plenty of room on that play, and they find their way to the 36.
Well, how about the offense setting that play up? We've seen earlier in the game a couple shorter throws. They're just trying to suck those safeties closer to the line of scrimmage, anticipating that they would get an opportunity to take a shot. They called the perfect play at the perfect time right there.
Perfect. Off the play fake on first down to throw. And it slips through his fingers, incomplete. That would have been a huge gain if he could have held on.
Quarterback could not have walked that ball and placed it into the hands of his receiver any better. That was a perfect throw. Wide out, deep downfield, you got to finish the play.
They'll go back to work after the incompletion. Here's second and 10 from the 36. He'll pull it on the read. Makes it past the marker. Really nice run there. Good, solid pickup, and they'll move the sticks for the first down.
Well, this is one of the fastest quarterbacks in college football, and that's why the option's a good idea, because if he can get out in space and he has a chance to get downfield, he is really difficult to tackle, and he's very difficult to catch, as you saw in that last play, getting a first down.
They're looking to pass from the red zone, and the pass is intercepted. Trying to take it back. He's inside the 40. He's at the 20. And he's going to run it all the way back. Touchdown, Sam Houston. What about the speed from that defender on the return?
He's showing you, Reese, like, listen, it's not just wide receivers that can do that. I can take this thing to the house. I got some moves. Watch this. Unbelievable job flipping the field. Offense about to score. Defense makes the huge plays and gets points out of it.
Ready to try the point after. The kick is up and good, and put one more on the lead. They're about to kick it away, and the defense probably can't wait to get back out there after the pick six. And he'll bring it out of the end zone. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. FIU gets it back, and the Panthers will send the offense back onto the field. Off the play fake on first down to throw. Just a little off. Incomplete.
Great job by the defense taking away the quarterback's primary target on that play and forcing the incompletion.
Now second and 10. From the gun, running back on the move. They shut it down quickly, but he gets two out to the 18. Defense showing plenty of pre-snap movement of their own. And the Panthers moving quickly to the line. On third down, going up top. It's caught. Coming through that third down conversion, and they'll mark it at the 43.
Well, look, that wasn't a touchdown. That was a massive play for this offense. They needed some momentum. They needed to find a rhythm, and what better way than converting on third down? Awesome job by the quarterback getting through his progression.
FIU comes out with a fresh set of downs. Use the play fake, now to throw. He tosses one high and deep down the left side. And it slips through his fingers, incomplete. That would have been a huge gain if he could have squeezed it.
Well, at this juncture in the game, with how the scoreboard looks, no question this offense is going to have to throw to get back in the game, and it's going to be tricky now because the defense is expecting it. You're going to throw into a lot of big zone coverages with everybody's eyes on the quarterback. Not going to be easy.
On the ground, it's Lawrence. Continuing to turn and move it forward, and they're closing in on midfield. It's down at the 48.
I think tackling is about effort most of the time. It's about how much passion, how much physicality you can bring to get your guy on the ground. Refuse not to get him on the ground. That's not a big back. You got to get that guy on the ground. You can't let him pick up an extra couple yards and stay ahead of the sticks.
On the move. Really tough run there. He got four. That'll leave him a yard short on fourth down. FIU will line up to punt. And these guys have been busy. Sixth punt of the day. And they'll keep it away from the return man as the punt goes out of bounds. The Bearcat offense ready to go back to work. Last time, David, it was 1-2-3 kick.
The last drive, that three and out, sometimes that puts your defense in a bad spot. And you got to get a drive together here so you don't wear the defense out.
I just think, David, too predictable that last drive. They got to do something here to get this defense on their heels.
Man, not much wiggle room for the ball carrier there.
Not really sure what they can do to try to create some space.
I know. Block better. How about the offensive lineman push some guy backwards and make some holes?
Got stuffed on first down. It's second and 10. Gives it to the back on the draw. They'll knock him down after a pickup of one to the 18.
They're strong and they're scrawled. Defensive tackles, they're scrawled. They're such big jokers in the middle where they just lock out those offensive linemen. And running backs, listen, they don't have much of a chance. When you got that 300-plus pound guy grabbing you around the shoulder pad, you tend to go to the ground pretty quickly.
Quarterback now breaking the field. Crosses the 30, he's got a lane. And maybe they've tried to spy on the quarterback, but it just hasn't worked. Another first down, he just keeps gashing them with his feet.
Man, that's so frustrating. And it happens so fast. He just pulls it down. It looks like pass. He pulls it down, and he's gone. Just like that, chewing up yards. So much speed, so hard to stop.
Caught in the backfield. It's Smith. And there were no creases or crevices to run through, and they shove him out of bounds.
Ooh, and that was close for the offense. They try to go wide receiver screen. They're counting on that receiver beating that defender. Wasn't able to make a miss that time, but if I'm on offense, I'm going back to that play later.
Offense gets set for second down. He'll do it himself. Picks up the first down, still moving. Found enough room to get it into enemy territory there down at the 43-yard line.
And when you got that kind of speed, football's got to be a lot of fun. I mean, Jesse, it's not there. Just pull it down. Go make a play.
That's definitely something that defense has never had to worry about in my day either. I think I just pulled a hamstring watching that guy go.
No question they wanted to get the ball to their playmakers, and both receivers have come up big through three. Back at it to open the quarter with this first down play. From the gun, leaves it on the inside with the back.
You know, it's so important for offenses to want to keep third downs manageable. The way you do that is by having success like that, running the football on first down.
Got three on first down. It's second and 7. They'll run the option. And the freshman does a great job using his technique and getting the man on the ground.
Yeah, and it's a nice job by this defense. Understand, listen, that QB is a threat. And they're going to run all kinds of options, and he's going to run the football. They were dialed in. He got that sucker to the ground.
They've started a pretty good drive. This will be the 7th play, but they need to convert 3rd and 5. Using his legs, it's Gentry. Across the 25, he's got room. He will step out of bounds, but not before the big pickup and a first down for this offense.
Yeah, and if this offense can keep that rolling, if they can keep the physical ground game and continue to add these plays up as they go along, long drives, eat the clock with the lead, this coach will be ecstatic.
To the ground, he's got it again. Dropped after a pickup of 4 down to the 16. Solid pickup of 4 on first down. It's 2nd and 6. trying to surprise him with the pass. Pressure coming. And a little too much adrenaline on that throw never gave his receiver a chance. Couldn't find his man last time, and that leaves him with a 3rd and 6. Running back goes in motion. Back to throw, it's Bauer. He's got it! Touchdown, Bearcats! And the stomping has commenced.
Yeah, salt enter wound, right? Late in the fourth quarter, you can run the football, run this game out. No, sir. I'm going to continue to pad my stats, find my receiver out wide, and get me another touchdown.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. And the extra point will tack another one onto this lead. An 84-yard drive there. And they close the deal with a 16-yard throw for the touchdown. Kickoff team has the ball teed up and they're about ready to go. And they thought about a return, then thought better of it. They'll bring it out to the 25. The Florida International offense is back on the field. That last drive fizzled out, Jesse. They had to punt it.
Yeah, they did. And David, they're just going to have to...
Oh, he's ready to take a shot. And he grabs it at the 15. Defense is there to make the stop, but he's got the first down, and they'll have it first and goal with the 6.
The offense has struggled. They're not going to win this game. But trust me, this coaching staff is still trying to find things to build off of for next week. And after an explosive play like that, maybe they can generate just a little bit of momentum and gain a little bit of confidence that they can keep coaching up heading into their next game.
On first and goal, let's see if FIU can get it in. Pre-snap motion in the backfield. Quick pass on the jet motion. Touchdown, FIU! And they made it to the house when they found that 6 points waiting on them.
And that's why this running back is so dangerous. It's not just handing him off the football, but he's a weapon in the passing game. You see his ability to catch it, turn upfield, make people miss, and find the end zone.
Play the analytics here, and you go for 2. To the air, it's Jenkins. The pressure gets to him. Quarterback is sacked, and the 2-point attempt is denied, and the lead stays right where it is. About to kick it off after punching it in for the touchdown. He'll bring it back from inside his 5. Not a lot of space to be found. Good hustle by the coverage team, and they stop him at the 21. The Bearcat offense ready to go back to work. If you like old-fashioned, grind-it-up, run-over-em football, that last touchdown drive was for you, Jesse.
That was impressive, man. Great blocking up front and tough physical running by these ball carriers, David.
And now you wonder how the defense responds. Like, are they going to get way more aggressive to try to stop the run? I got to do something to break the rhythm of that running game.
After picking up a couple, it's 2nd and 8. Leaves it with the running back. Picks his way and gets 4 out to the 27.
I think they called that knowing they weren't going to hit a home run. So why would you call it then? Well, you call it so 3rd down becomes an easier down. It's not 3rd and long where I have to pass the football. Now all options on the table.
They'll try to move the chains on third and short from the 27. And the incomplete pass will bring up fourth down.
I think in this situation, after that incompletion, fourth and short on your side of the field, the smart play is to punt it away and trust your defense.
And the Bearcats will punt this one away. He'll call for the fair catch here. Guys, FIU ready to go back to work on offense. To the air, it's Jenkins. Pocket starts to collapse. And the quarterback is snowed under. They'll tell you that somebody's always going to pop open, but it didn't happen in time before they got the sack.
No, it did not. And you know what? I'm going to remember this. I'm going to remember zone defense. They didn't really have an answer. They weren't ready to get rid of the football. Quarterback hesitated. I got to him and got him on the ground. Might be a good call later on in the game.
They'll try to put it in drive this time on second down from the 22. He's looking to throw. Makes the catch. It's Lewis.
I love the QB here. He holds it just long enough to let the receiver run the drag route. Then he puts it out in front of him so he can catch it on the run in stride and then turn upfield to use his speed.
And that last completion left them short of the sticks. It's third down. They'll try to get it through the air. Didn't have anything working and just had to throw it away on third down.
It's a nice adjustment by the defense here. With a big lead in the game, you're putting extra DBs on the field, knowing the offense has to throw to get back in this one in the fourth quarter. So your best cover guys on the field, and they force an incompletion on the last one.
Down by multiple possessions, you can't come up empty on this drive. They'll go for it on fourth down. And he's brought down after a nice game. Well, the head coach said he was going to be aggressive. Fourth and two is kind of right on that edge, but he goes for it and gets it done.
He said he was going to be aggressive, and he backed it up. That's one thing you want to see. You want to hear your coaches talk, and you want to see them back it up on the field.
The Panthers are in the hurry up. They'll ride the hot hand. Not much working there. It'll be second and nine. Offense, quick tempo. To the air, it's Jenkins. Feeling some heat. Gets away from one, finds some space. And he has a solid gain on the play before sliding.
Well, great job there by the defense because they weren't able to get him sacked right away, but you saw the coverage in the back end. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football. Didn't get the sack, obviously. You don't get the negative play, but you also don't give up a big one. You're feeling pretty good about where you are right now in this drive.
A lot of urgency for this offense. They're going to go to the air on third and short. Getting some heat. Pressure's there, and he gets rid of it.
And the quarterback gets hit again. We already know this defense has gotten home to him multiple times in this game. So here you are. You're trailing in the game. Defense knows you're going to throw it. They're pinning their ears back. You can't feel very confident right now if you're the play caller and certainly if you're the quarterback that you're going to have time to throw.
Down by multiple possessions, they can't come up empty on this drive in the fourth quarter. They'll go for it on fourth down. On the move at the 30. And they'll finally bring him down after he rips off a huge play.
What a run. Great speed, great vision, elusiveness, and David, he's tackled down close to the goal line.
Yeah, and this offense, when you can run the football like this, man, you will have success, especially in the red zone, trying to get touchdowns.
FIU set up with another first down. He wants to throw. Unleashes to the end zone. And he's got it! Touchdown, Panthers!
And it's so underrated. The relationship between a QB and a wide receiver, the timing, the ability to know where he's going to be and be accurate with the football, that's what leads to nice touchdowns, Jesse.
Well, and the chemistry between these two guys has to be great when you're throwing into the end zone, because coverage is going to be tight. The throw might not be perfect, but this is something these two guys have been repping in practice over and over and over, and it's paying dividends now on game day.
On to attempt the try. Bangs it through for an extra point. They march 79 yards on the drive, and they finish it off by connecting from 10 yards out. They are running out of time here. They need to get the ball back. They'll line up for the onside kick. Few anxious moments there, but the hands team, true to its name, as they make the grab and get the ball. The Bearcat offense ready to go back to work. They had to punt it away on their last possession, but man, what great field position this time.
I mean, this is awesome. Like, last possession didn't go great. Now you're set up in an opportunity to get some points. Start thinking about what plays I like, Jesse, as I cross the 50.
There are a lot of offensive coordinators out there, David, and in this position, they like to take a shot right away and try and capitalize on this field position.
We've reached a two-minute warning, and this offense will be quite content just to drain the rest of the time away. They got nothing on the last play. It's second and 10. They'll run it to keep the clock moving. One step wrap, two step squeeze. This junior knows how to get him on the ground. Quick timeout called by the defense, stopping the clock to save as much time as possible for their offense. Big third down play here. If they get a stop, you'll see an immediate timeout. From the shotgun, the inside give. And he's not going to get there. The defense stands tall and makes the stop. Defense uses a timeout quickly, trying to get that ball back and preserve time for their offense. And they're running out the kicker to give it a try. He'll need to unleash his thunderfoot on this 56-yard attempt from the right hash. And that is no good. After the miss, the lead still at 11.
Well, that's now the second missed field goal for this kicker. And I tell you this, you can't blame the weather for all this. This is a beautiful day. He needs to do better executing these field goals.
FIU gets it back, and the Panthers will send the offense back onto the field. That running game was impressive, taking them right down for a touchdown last time, David.
Yeah, just mauling. No secret play calls, just simply, we are more physical than you, and we're pounding the football right at you.
So if you're on offense this next drive, take a look at their safeties and see if they're creeping up into the box. Because of your success running the football, this might be time to take a shot down the field and play action.
They'll hurry to the line with the clock still running. Looking for a man. It's Jenkins. Nowhere to go, and the ball is loose. They recover their own fumble. How in the world did the offense avoid that disaster?
Whew. Deep breath, right? Man, you fumble that thing, you cough it up. You're like, oh, I really appreciate you, brother. I can't tell you how much I thank you, because the coaches would have been all over me, but big time break for the offense.
Got to get to the line quickly for this third down play. Looking to throw, and he needs a bunch. And a missed opportunity on third down as the defense knocks it free, and fourth down is coming up.
And now such a tough situation. Late in this game, you're trailing, but now it's fourth and long. Like, it's one thing if it's fourth and short. This makes it even more difficult. You got to have something dialed up you feel really great about.
On fourth down, going to the air. He's taking a deep shot late in the game. Fires into traffic. It's picked off. And a big return after the INT sets up the offense for this possession.
And that's a really good job by the defense, understanding the situation of football. It's fourth down. It's late in the game. You got a multi-possession lead. Take away all the deep stuff. Make them force the football into coverage. They do, and they stamp this game.